Hi, welcome to this video. In this video, I will be talking about two sample Z tests for independent samples, where my population variances are known and or I have large samples. If the population variances are unknown, but the sample sizes are large, we can use the sample variances in place of the population variances. We will look at the following example. Test the claim at 1% level of significance that there is no difference between the average salaries of financial advisors and business analysts in Ontario. A random sample of 33 financial advisors and 46 business analysts were selected across the whole province. The following table contains means from both samples and the population standard deviations. Construct a 99% confidence interval for the difference between the population means. The information is shown in the table here. Now, the claim in this question is there is no difference between the average salaries. So my population mean 1 is equal to population mean 2. My claim is therefore the null hypothesis. Mu 1 equals to mu 2, or mu 1 minus mu 2 is equal to 0. My alternative is mu 1 is not equal to mu 2, or mu 1 minus mu 2 is not equal to 0. From this information given, we can compute the test statistic with the formula given here. My x1 bar is the sample mean for the first sample, x2 bar, sample mean for the second sample, sigma 1, population standard deviation for the first sample, sigma 2, population standard deviation for the second sample, n1, the sample size for sample 1, N2, sample size for sample 2. D0 is the hypothesized mean difference between the population means, which is mu1 minus mu2 in this question, which is 0. When all these values are put into the formula, we arrive at a test statistic of -2.16. Next, we find the critical value. By typing this formula right here into any cell in Excel. Alpha is 0.01. Since it is a two-tail test, the area on one tail will be alpha divided by 2, which will be 0.005. Once we type this into Excel, it returns the critical value, -2.575. This value can also be obtained by using the standard normal table. As a result of that, we see in this standard normal curve, the area on either tail is alpha over 2, which is 0.005, and the respective critical value, 2.575 on the right tail and -2.575 on the left tail. The test statistic falls outside the rejection region, since the critical value is less than the test statistic. So we fail to reject the null hypothesis. We can also find the p-value by typing this formula into any cell in Excel. Since it's a two-tailed test, we are going to be multiplying that value by 2. Note here that we are putting in the test statistic in here. The p-value obtained, which is greater than alpha. So the decision is the same. We fail to reject the null hypothesis. We can thus conclude that at 1% level of significance, we have sufficient evidence to support the claim. The claim in this case, again, is the null hypothesis. Next, we compute the 99% confidence interval for mu1 minus mu2. We use this formula right here. All of these values have been given from the table earlier on. The critical value again on one tail is 2.575. Once we put in all our values in here, The product here, the value we have on the right side here, is referred to as the margin of error. And in here, we have the difference between the sample means. When we compute this, the difference between the sample means is negative 3,150. And the margin of error is 3,745.67. We use these values to compute the upper confidence limit by taking the difference between the sample means plus the margin of error, and the lower confidence limit by taking the difference between the sample means minus the margin of error. Once we get the upper confidence limit and the lower confidence limit, we can write down our confidence interval in this way. If we notice, zero fall in this interval. So as a result of that, we say that there is no significant difference between the population means. Hence, we fail to reject the null hypothesis. This supports the decision we made earlier on in the first part of the question. We can go ahead and interpret the confidence interval by saying that we are 99% confident that the population mean difference is between negative 6,895.67 and 595.67. Thank you for watching this video.